Welcome to today's video. Today's video, I've got a product review of the OHME smart cable from OHME. The cable allows you to do various things. One of them is it allows you to use Octopus's Agile tariff, Octopus's Go tariff. But if you're not an Octopus customer, a couple of the other things it can do, it can stop your charge at certain percentages. It can do sort of charge delays as well if your car charge delay doesn't work or can require subscriptions like the Zoe when that runs out. But it can allow your car to do so much stuff. So let me go into what it does and show you exactly what this cable does this week. So a couple of things just to get into that you might want to know first about this cable. It is, like I said, only compatible with an untethered unit. Basically, you plug this into your untethered unit like you'd normally your Type 2 to Type 2 plug, and this box here makes everything smart. It's got a SIM card in here. When you buy the OHME cable, it comes with a 2-year subscription with the SIM card. Now, if you are supported by an energy company like Octopus, and other energy companies are probably talking to OHME at the moment, according to my sources, so it might not be the only company that Octopus is going to deal with OHME, it might be other energy firms as well. So it's likely that they will carry on supporting the subs for the box in here. So a couple of questions to get out of the way. It is basically a Type 2 to Type 2 cable for your house. You wouldn't really take this out in public. However, there will be some uses that this can do on public chargers, but not just yet. We'll get into them in a minute. But first of all you do, plug this into your untethered unit. It only works for an untethered unit at the moment. It is available in a Type 2 plug, it's available in a commando plug, and it's available in a 3-pin granny cable plug. The 3-pin granny cable, Type 2 and commando are all £200 if you buy it direct through Octopus, which is highly subsidised. In fact, buying a 3-pin granny cable in this version would make it probably one of the cheapest granny cables possible for a Zoe or any other car. Now, I have tested the 3-pin granny cable, which I haven't got with me today, but when the kind bloke from OHME dropped this off, I tested it on a Zoe, I tested it on the BMW. It does work with both cars, works with Teslas, and they've tested it on some of the various models and stuff like that. I'm also going to be testing this on the Zoe and the BMW to make sure it's completely compatible with both. And so far, my tests have been flawless. Nothing's gone wrong yet. Before I get into the product anymore, can I ask you just to do 3 things for me? First of all, can you like this video? Second of all, can you click subscribe down below at the bottom? And last but not least, please share this video with a family and friend member to help them get into EVs. Now at the moment, the main uses for this cable for the majority of people, if you're on Octopus Go, you can set it to only charge on your Octopus Go tariff. They have all the Octopus tariffs built into the system, so you select what tariff you're on, etc. And it will basically just use that tariff information that you've got to charge when it's clean, cheap, or green. And also you can customize by swiping off these certain features. So you can only charge when it's green, you can only charge when it's cheap, or you can have a mixture of both of them, or none of them, and you can just charge whenever. So it has a lot of flexibility in what the cable can do and what it's capable of. In the future, it's going to be used by the National Grid for shed loading. So let's say there's too much energy on the grid and they need someone to absorb it, and your car's plugged in, they can basically turn on everyone's charge and start sucking power out of the grid very quickly. And that's probably what the grid are going to be the most useful for, and you'll probably be incentivized and paid to do stuff like this. However, if you're on Agile Octopus, the idea of Agile Octopus is if there is a surplus of energy, you get paid to take it off the grid, or you take it at a very, very, very cheap rate. In the future, they are working to hopefully integrate this smart box to work with solar. So if you were exporting from the grid, it would be able to see what your smart meter is exporting and then try and match the export by putting it into the car instead. So there's a lot of things that it can do, which it's not capable of yet, but they're coming. So at the moment, the things it's capable of, working with Agile Octopus, working with Octopus Go, stopping your charge rate at 80%. Now it does this by talking to the API on your car. So what you do is you log into your car's API system on the OHME app, and then it basically reads all the car settings. So at the moment, the Renault Zoe sadly, unfortunately, isn't currently supported during this demo period that I'm testing it, but I've been promised that they are working on the API for all the Zoe, and it will come out soon. So at the moment, there is BMW, Tesla, and Nissan. The early generation Nissans, they have a few complications dealing with, because the old generation Nissan didn't give them the correct data they needed, so they have a little bit of a software fix on there to, for because sometimes you'll get more battery fill than you were asked for, and that's because it's optimizing for the miles and not for the actual range. And it's just something to do with the way the old API worked. On the newer Leafs, it basically, you say the percentage, it'll pretty much hit it dead on the nail. Staying with the BMW, first day I tested it, there was a fault. I did ring OHME, they did some product testing and investigating, and they fixed it. I've tested it every single day now on a set percentage of 80, I've tried 90, I've tried 60, I've tried 40, and it stopped exactly those charge percentages that I've asked for. Now you might ask, why would you want to do this? And the reason is, if you're not in a Renault Zoe, which has got a lease battery, which Renault will be paying for if it goes wrong, if you're in a BMW or a Tesla or something like that, now Teslas at the moment can stop at a 90% charge. They do that automatically unless you request it to go to 100. But on other cars like BMWs and Nissan Leafs, you can't choose to do this. But with the OHME app, because it's reading the API, it will stop the charge as soon as you get to that percentage. And what it does is it keeps checking the API of the car, the data of the car from the car app. As soon as it sees you've hit that percentage, it stops the charge, which is great if, you know, for like me, that you're going to keep a car for a long period of time and you want to preserve that state of health. If you keep the state of charge of that battery between 20 and 80%, or even 30 to 70%, you're keeping it in the prime sort of part of the battery. Now, BMS's on-car systems do protect you from a 100% charge and a 0% charge, but even if you kept it at full 100% for a week, it would slowly start damaging the battery, even though it's not a true 100%. So it is better to keep it at lower rates, especially if you're not doing high mileage. It's a lot better for the battery long term. So that's what I really, really like about this app so far. One of the really cool things I think about the app at the moment is you're able to see cost per mile. Now it does this because it's linked into your energy tariff if you're on Octopus, and it knows exactly what you're paying per kilowatt of electricity across the Agile or Octopus Go tariff. It knows roughly what the BMW or the Zoe does in watt miles or miles per kilowatt, whichever conversion you like, instead of the miles per gallon for petrol or ICE cars, but I like to use miles per kilowatt. It basically tells you what that cost per mile is. Now, they're not currently reading the API data from BMW, which tells you what the last trip did miles per kilowatt. They're using averages, what they know the car does from statistics. But they are possibly thinking about adapting the API to take in consideration what the last trip was and then producing the cost per mile there. So they're always developing the OHME app and the way the cable works, and I think that's quite an innovative of the way it works. Now, Agile, if you don't know how Agile works, by the way, if you want to join Octopus, there's a link down below in my description. You get £50 if you join. There's two tariffs on Octopus. One is the Octopus Go tariff that I've done a video on before, link at the top right if you want to know more about that. The other one is Agile Octopus. Now this is better for people who've got multiple EVs or Teslas and they basically don't want to be restricted to just charging at night. Agile Octopus prices change half an hourly. So every half an hour, there's a price change on Agile tariff. And what this cable will do is you can optimize it only to charge when electricity is cheap. And it looks at the Agile tariff and it goes, right, in this half an hour period, electricity is only 2p. In this half an hour period, electricity is only 8p. In this electricity period, we're going to be paid to charge the car. And it will optimize to charge in those periods. Now, it does this by you telling the car when you need the miles by, what charge you need by, and what time you need it by. And it will look across the board to ensure you get that charge, but done at the cheapest rate. And that is just clever all round. Now, the Zappy 2 and Zappy 1, I believe, will be capable of doing this. There's a link to the top right to the Zappy video I did, but they're not currently available to do it now. And if you've got a charger already, which a lot of people already have got EVs and chargers, and you have an untethered unit, this is a cheaper way of doing it without fitting a brand new charger to your house. To set up this little cable, what you need to do here is scan this barcode here on the app, and then takes you through all the procedures. It'll take you through the car's API and setting that up, and it's fairly straightforward to use. The app could do with a couple of improvements, but I've been told by OHME they are constantly innovating and listening to customers' feedback to constantly change it and adapt it to make it better. The main question I think you all want to know is, should you buy it? And my honest answer is, I think it's well worth the £200. If you haven't got a granny cable at the moment, it's a cheap granny cable. If you want to buy a granny cable, buy it, it's £200. If you end up using some of the smart features, great. If not, you've bought a very cheap granny cable. The other benefits to it I see is if you've got a Zoe or a BMW i3 where the charge delays are absolutely pants, then this can let you schedule charges that only start at certain times, and that just makes it better for me all round, because at the moment this has a mind of its own sometimes on when the iDrive decides it wants to charge the car, and the Zoe at the moment is beating the BMW on when it would like to charge the thing, but it has got its own bugs, and I've had bugs with the Zoe charge delay in the past, and I've had to use the app instead of the thing on the car. Some people find it the other way round, and it's just outright annoying. And also you have to pay for the subs on the Zoe if you do want the charge delay. Where if you buy this for £200, you've got it all built in. But sadly, if you have got a tether unit, you can't use it. There is some other things that could happen in the future which might make this even more appealing, and that is the commando socket. You can buy a commando socket version of this. If you could buy a commando socket version of this, you can have a commando socket fitted at your house by any electrician, and then just plug this straight in and have an EV charger. It doesn't comply to regs for an EV charger, but then you're not fitting an EV charger, you're fitting a commando socket, so they don't have to do a lot of the regs, which makes the prices cheaper. However, you could argue that you might want some of these benefits. Now, other things this does do, which for safety, even if you haven't bought the granny version, it has got DC leakage protection. That is a requirement on all new granny cables that are manufactured now. They must have DC leakage protection. And because this uses the same box as the granny cable and the same box as all the others, it has got DC leakage protection built in. What I wish they did do is, instead of fitting this on the end of here, that you had a little box with a peripheral port, a bit like what Tesla give you, and you could swap this cable out to a granny cable, to a commando socket and various others, and then you've got a really versatile charging system. But sadly they haven't. So like I said, this at the moment is only really used for home charging, but what you will be able to do in the future, I believe OHME have told me and assured me they are working on partners, is billing systems. So they'll be able to work with billing systems of public chargers and maybe recognize the cable and then just bill to a centralized account. They said it has obviously got the ability to talk to it and do stuff like that. So there might be people like the lamppost charge people who have similar looking boxes with numbers on, they might allow them to operate onto their billing system. So if you got to one of those lamppost chargers that you need one of those special boxes for, you plug this in, it recognises this box, talks to the SIM card and does the billing and metering, because this does monitor how many units you're using, etc. Thank you very much to OHME and Octopus for giving me the cable for testing. It's been a great bit of fun for me, a little bit of a change for me doing a product test of an actual product rather than a vehicle. And it's really, really blew me away how impressive I was. I wasn't too sure how impressed I was going to be with the cable, but now I've had to use it and got to play with it, I'm really, really, really impressed with it. So thank you very much, OHME. Thank you very much, Octopus. Thank you very much for you for watching and subscribing to my channel. And I'll see you again next week. Thanks very much and goodbye.